the future is going, where you really start putting a story together. The story, for example, that you just explained, you start putting a story together on the ground and you see how you want to experiment with yarns and, you know, the techniques, you know, which are used to create the fabric. You see how you can create ideas. There's so much happening in Jaipur as well with block print and, yeah. So Bagru is the main center. So you, when you have access to all these, you know, amazing, you know, places where you can work on the ground, have you just gone to the market and sourced, you know, all the amazing luxury fabrics that you have and done some surface ornamentation and given it some cuts, which maybe for a buyer is a great idea, right? But for the runway, is it something new and inspiring, or would look for how much work you put on the ground, how is it, that's where originality as a criteria, you know, would play a big role. And you know, why did you choose to work with Nikhil? Why is it your inspiration? Is it because you are close to Kochampalli?
No. In my college, so my final end of project was on Nikhil. It was a group of 7 weavers that I was helping out. It's a long story. Basically, they are in debt, and this is the way that the government was helping them to get out of their debt. So I worked with them closely, and I love the technique. So I wanted to get back to it. But see, working with handlooms, the thing is, we cannot mass produce stuff. We cannot be fast in our production. That's why so many years it took me a lot of years to, you know, get back to my textile designing. I was, you know, more into buying ready and making it. But this year I'm like, now
but
I have...
But the reason you chose Kochampalli is because you did some project with them.
Yeah, and I'm close, like I really
and
like
them. And then you could identify with their problems on the ground. So again, as designers, I think our responsibility is to think less. And at least when you start to think less about, you know, I would say commercial aspects, because that will come at a particular stage. And think more about what contribution you can make to, you know, design, which is design and what is around you in terms of your supply chain. So if you hear her story, I find that, you know, more stronger and more realistic and grounded in terms of why she would choose to work with Kochampalli, with the weavers, you know, who are going through some hardships. And then introduce some resistance in income seems to me like a new story, right? So, you know, that's where you start developing a contemporary product for a younger market. Again, our fashion week is extremely oriented more towards youth. So, are you creating a product that again would work with the mature consumers, which so many designers are anyways doing? Or are you creating a new language which is going to work with a consumer who is young and affluent? You need not have a product which is very expensive. You could even have something, you know, you could even make a nice top which is for 4,000 rupees. But the idea is, has more design in it than I would say the actual garment, right? Which is where your creativity, you know, plays a big role. So how are you addressing the younger demographic as a market is where I think the fashion week would look at? And introducing these kind of new techniques and finding inspiration to work with things which you are connected to, you know, that come from what is around you, rather than getting carried away with, let's say, an international trend or a theme, you know, and then we're not able to justify it in a realistic way. So another main thing that I would say is always start also imagining who is going to be wearing your product and, you know, think from that point of view. Which is where, as emerging designers, I think that's where we would look at, you know, from a fashion perspective. So, can you elaborate now what kind of, so from the fabric development, let's go to the product development, you know. So, what kind of collection are you visualizing coming out of this story?
It will be mostly contemporary silhouettes. It will have long jackets, it will have pants, a lot of footwear. So with this fabric, where all we can use it, you know, it will be a little heavier, heavy base fabric. So we can
and
make.
Who is that one lady? Can you describe her who would wear this, buy this? Somebody that you personally know?
I know a lot of people who would love to wear.
But just one character, can you sketch it and say this is, she's 25 or whatever, and this is her lifestyle, and this is what her body is, you know?
Oh, okay. I have a friend. So she is a photographer. She's a corporate photographer. So she doesn't wear those corporate suits and stuff. She really hates wearing something like that. So if I make jackets like that, if I'm making pants like that, she will love wearing something like that and going to office.
Yeah.
So it can replace your formal wear and make it a little more fun.
So this is another, you know, learning that we should start with a sketch of one character who is our muse as a customer, and we should really visualize, you know, what we are trying to create from that fabric which we've developed. You know, is it really going to sell? Is somebody really going to buy? Because what you often see on the runway looks extremely good for the models, but the real customer is a size 12 or 14 or 16 probably, and depends on your pricing. So you should really have that sense when you're sketching and when you're sampling, you know, that who is that person who's going to accept this particular product. And then as an emerging designer, you start creating a more mature aesthetic, and as fashion week, start appreciating that rather than trying to go more experimental and creating something just for the runway, which really, you know, maybe the buyer will find it hard to order and may seem quite impractical. So that's the first step, is how are you getting inspired to do something? So what are you seeing around you? What are you feeling connected to? Is there a relationship that you have, you know, with elements that are inspiring you, with the fabric, with the, let's say, the color story that you're trying to put together, the patterns that you're trying to put together? And then going on to doing actual fabric development on the ground, and then going on to creating a product, sketching a, you know, a real muse who is a customer and a character for you, and then expanding, you know, that thought process and working on your collection. This is where, you know, I think going through this process is where you would yourself realize, you know, what works, what doesn't work, and what will put a strong sort of a story and a connection together. With Fashion Week again, and your mind needs to work in a nice and creative way, but also in a, you know, process and structured way. And then you should be able to present a line which looks serious for the buyer, you know, to order. I would say with emerging designers, as Fashion Week, I would look for how ready to order or ready to sell is your line. At the same time, you know, certain elements that can give that freshness to it. So like she mentioned, the resist dyeing that she's doing on curves. I don't know how you're planning to put it together. It shouldn't look, let's say, hodgepodge.
No.
Yeah. And the colors that you're trying to use, you know, it shouldn't look too crowded or chaotic, right? So if it turns out to look like an interesting design reinterpretation, you know, that speaks for itself. So that's a fresh element in a heritage story of Nikhil. And then if you create a strong jacket out of it, a structured, you know, garment that would work for your kind of buyer, then it kind of looks like a well put together practical piece. And then as fashion,
First of all, I'd like to say that 6 Degrees, the initiative that they had started, which is the Get LFW, once again. first of all, I'd like to say that get LFW ready. The initiative that 6 Degree has started, bahut zarurat thi iski, bahut zyada zarurat thi. My association with LFW goes back to 2013. Tab se maine aaj tak nahi suna hai kuch aisa hua ho jahan par India ke various states se, you know, there are many upcoming budding designers who are wanting to be a part of Lakme Fashion Week, that there was anything which would prepare them for it. So this Get LFW Ready platform, how did we choose the designers? So there were many applications that came. Ab usme se kuch log ek level tak prepared hote hain, kuch thode aur level tak prepared hote hain. So obviously because it is Lakme Fashion Week, so we had to keep in mind that they were a certain level, they are coming with a certain level of preparation. So puri India mein se jo applications aaye, usme se 9 hum logon ne choose kiye for going ahead and being a part of this mentoring program. So the people who are there, I have to say there is some future that we see for all of them. However, sab log to Fashion Week mein nahi showcase kar sakte hain. So there is, they are carrying their collections, what they are planning to showcase, or they're carrying their work for us to go ahead and see actually from sketching stage to banane tak, what is the ready garment looking like. So we can go ahead and grade them, and then isme se kuch designers jo hain, unko select kiya jayega, who will be then going ahead and showcasing at Lakme Fashion Week.
There were selected 9.
There are 9 of them, yes.
And out of them, how many they performed in Lakme Fashion Week?
So that is a number that is still under discussion. See, the best thing was, this is a very holistic kind of a program. So isme kyunki kuch designers hain jo kafi saal ke experience ke sath aa rahe hain aur kuch designers hain who are coming with very little years of number of years of experience. So similar were the mentors. So like I am the program director, so I was supposed to go ahead and bring a perspective to them that, because I am the main showreel director for Lakme Fashion Week as well, to what happens at Lakme Fashion Week so that they can go ahead and prepare themselves. Secondly, I am an image consultant. So what is image? What is brand building? So ye to tha unse related. Now comes the kind of collections. So there is a Lakme Fashion Week representative who's here, who's telling them what they look for. There are designers like Yogesh Chaudhary, who's an established category. Then there is Ajay, who's an emerging designer. Then there is Firoza Dalal, who has been one of the most well-known buyers for the country, for many stores that are there in this in India. So various facets of them being a fashion designer, of how they can sell, where they can sell, how they can participate, where they can participate, everything has been covered, starting with them, from them to their work. So it has been a very great holistic experience for all of them, I think, whosoever is here.
Let's come to, again, Lakme Fashion Week. What fashion lovers can expect from these new talents?
From these?
New talents.
See, fashion is a creative process, right? And fashion trends keep changing. Like I tell everybody, fashion is you. What you believe you are comfortable in wearing, that is fashion for you. When it comes to these designers, everybody comes with their own creative genes. They have their own sensibilities. So to go ahead and put this expectation on them that what the world should expect out of them, I think it's too soon. But yes, each one of them have their individual sensibilities. So I'm thinking that there are 9 new ideas that are going to be presented to the world.
And how do you see Indian designers compared to other foreign designers?
India is a growing economy, right? So I think every field in India is growing. So similarly, I'll put the fashion designers as well. Obviously, internationally, you know, the exposure, the kind of talent, the kind of training, the kind of grooming that is there, I think they're a little ahead of us. However, having said so, hamara Indian bridal market still, I think, is the strongest.
We don't have competition.
There is no competition. Shadi market mein India ka koi competition kahin nahi hai duniya mein.
Even the company has said about, yeah. Thank you so much for talking to us.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much. Really appreciate it.
Thank you. Yes. Thanks, Ravi. Thank you. Hope you got the matter what you wanted.
Then restart. Roll. Okay. Right.
What would you say your
Thank you so much for all the things. But huh, काफ़ी अच्छा है मतलब इट्स अ वेरी गुड इनिशिएटिव एंड आई एम हैप्पी कि समबडी इज़ थिंकिंग इन दैट मैनर और बहुत अच्छा चीज़ हो रहा है बिकॉज समटाइम क्या होता है कि कुछ नए लोग जो होते हैं उनको पता नहीं चलता कि हम क्या चीज़ सही करें क्या गलत करें या फिर क्या चीज़ हो रहा है क्या करना चाहिए और ये एक जो इनिशिएटिव है बहुत अच्छा है जो कि दूसरे लोगों को ज़रूर हेल्प करेगा जो अपकमिंग लोग हैं जो पार्टिसिपेट करना चाहते हैं कल के दिन दे वॉन्टेड टू लॉन्च देयर ओन लेबल तो उनके लिए डेफिनेटली है बिकॉज दे आर कॉलिंग एक्सपर्ट्स फ्रॉम द सेम फील्ड फ्रॉम लैक्मे एंड ऑल एंड दे आर शेयरिंग देयर ओन एक्सपीरियंस देयर ओन जर्नी फॉर ऑल दिस थिंग सो डेफिनेटली इट हेल्प्स बहुत अच्छी ये है इनिशिएटिव्स है इनका सिक्स डिग्री का इट्स गुड क्या देखिए मेरा मानना यही है कि पोटेंशियल सब में है एवरीबडी हैज़ अ पोटेंशियल एंड एवरीबडी इज़ इंडिविजुअल तो आपका जो लेबल होता है फैशन लेबल जो आपका होता है जो ब्रांड होता है वो बेसिकली अ इंडिविजुअल थिंग है जो आप पोट्रे करते हो अंटिल अनलेस आप अपने में से वो चीज़ नहीं निकालोगे कि ये मैं हूँ ये मेरा कलेक्शन है तब तक वो आएगा नहीं तो सब हाँ सब यूनिक है मैं यूनिक पैदा हुआ हूँ आप यूनिक पैदा हुए हैं एवरीबडी हैज़ दे हैव बॉर्न यूनिक सो एवरीबडी शुड बिहेव लाइक कि आई एम यूनिक सो आई हैव टू क्रिएट समथिंग विच विल क्रिएट अ नीस विच विल क्रिएट अ यूनिक थिंग एंड ऑफ द डे इट्स अ मार्केट कॉल बिजनेस कॉल एंड ऑल विच एवरीबडी वॉन्ट्स टू डू बट अनटिल अनलेस अगर हम वो चीज़ क्रिएट नहीं करेंगे वो यूनिकनेस नहीं क्रिएट करेंगे वो अपनी पोजीशन नहीं क्रिएट करेंगे वो पोजीशन कैसे क्रिएट होगा मार्केट में वो अपने प्रोडक्ट से ही होगा नहीं तो फिर होगा नहीं अब जब तक मैं अलग नहीं रहूँगा जब तक अपना क्रिएट नहीं कर पाऊँगा तो एवरीबडी हैज़ अ पोटेंशियल ये बस टाइम मैटर है कि वो अपने आप को कितना समझ पाते हैं और जब वो समझेंगे देन इट्स वेरी गुड एवरीबडी हैज़ अ पोटेंशियल नहीं देखिए अब नाउ तो ऐसा लगता है मुझे कि ये सारी चीज़ें अभी ब्लर हो रही हैं ये सारी डिस्टेंस अभी ब्लर हो रहे हैं पहले जैसा नहीं रह गया पहले क्या होता था कि हम वेस्ट की तरफ देखते थे हम इंस्पायर होते थे उनसे क्योंकि हमारी जो डेवलपमेंट हुई है स्टार्ट हुई है वो बहुत लेट हुई है उनसे नाउ हम उस टाइम पे हैं जब हम डेवलप हो रहे हैं तो हमारी जर्नी अब स्टार्ट हुई है और हमारा जो पेस है वो बहुत अच्छा है तो ऐसा नहीं है कि दे आर गुड दे आर ऑब्वियसली उनका क्या है दे हैव वो लोग पहले से काम कर रहे हैं सो वो इवॉल्व पहले हुए हैं हमने थोड़ा लेट स्टार्ट किया तो हम थोड़ा लेट इवॉल्व होंगे लेकिन हम होंगे तो हमारे डिज़ाइनर्स में भी बहुत पोटेंशियल है अभी बहुत सारे लोग हैं हमारे बहुत सारे जो डिज़ाइनर्स हैं उन्होंने बहुत इंटरनेशनल अवार्ड जीते हैं जो कि इंडियन डिज़ाइनर्स हैं तो ये चीज़ तो हो ही रहा है क्योंकि एक्सपोजर सबके लिए अभी बराबर हो गया है मैं अगर ट्रैवल ना करूँ वेस्टर्न कंट्रीज़ में तब भी कोई मतलब नहीं होता आई कैन सी थिंग्स मैं नेट पे देख सकता हूँ मैं टीवी पे देख सकता हूँ मैं देख सकता हूँ कि कुछ अच्छा हो रहा है कुछ अच्छी चीज़ें होती है मेरी एक्सपोजर बहुत बढ़ गई है अब ऐसा नहीं है कि अब हम अभी ग्लोबल हो गए अभी हम हर जगह हो गए हैं है ना तो हम बोलते हैं ग्लोबल लोकल हो गया है अभी सो इट्स बिकम लाइक दैट तो अभी वो सब चीज़ें नहीं हैं सब लोग अच्छे हो गए हैं सब लोग में एवरीबडी हैज़ अ पोटेंशियल हाँ हमारी एक सर्टेन तरीका है काम करने का वेस्टर्न लोगों का एक सर्टेन तरीका काम करने का तो एवरी डिज़ाइनर हैज़ देयर ओन थिंग एवरी कंट्री एवरी सोसाइटी हैज़ अ डिफरेंट काइंड ऑफ वर्किंग राइट हम अपने फंक्शन में ट्राई करते हैं कि हम इंडियन वेयर ही पहने करेक्ट ना हम पे वही अच्छा लगता है अगर हमारी इंडियन वेडिंग हो रही है तो इंडियन साड़ी ही अच्छी लगती है हमारी दुल्हन पे राइट कुर्ता पजामा ही अच्छा लगता है शेरवानी ही अच्छा लगता है सिमिलरली उनके लिए तो उनका गाउन है उनके टक्सीडोज हैं तो अलग अलग चीज़ें हैं तो कहीं ना कहीं सब सारी मर्च होती राइट हाँ तो वही मैं बोल रहा था कि पहले हम वेस्ट की तरफ देखते थे अब लोग हमारे ईस्ट की तरफ देख रहे हैं अब हमारे तरफ देखना स्टार्ट किया लोगों ने कि यार कुछ तो हो रहा है इधर जो कि बहुत अच्छा हो रहा है तो वही मैं बोल रहा था कि वेस्ट में क्या हुआ कि दे हैव डन इट एंड उन्होंने एक जर्नी स्टार्ट की थी, दे हैव डन, दे हैव एक्सपीरियंस एंड नाउ दे आर स्टैग्नेंट. हमारी तो अभी स्टार्ट हुई है, तो हमारे लिए तो एक्सप्लोरेशन का टाइम अभी है, तो अभी तो है, मतलब इट्स वेरी गुड टाइम फॉर अस डेफिनेटली. मीन्स कॉम्पिटिशन नहीं होता यार, कॉम्पिटिशन नहीं होता. आप किससे कॉम्पीट कर रहे हो, मतलब कॉम्पिटिशन कुछ भी नहीं होता. कॉम्पिटिशन मेरे लिए पर्सनल ऐसा है कि यू हैव टू बी कॉम्पिटिटिव हमेशा. आप कॉम्पिटिटिव अगर नहीं रहोगे तो यू विल नॉट एबल टू सक्सीड और यू विल नॉट एबल टू प्रोसीड. आप किसी को देख के इंस्पायर हो सकते हो बट डोंट मेक इट कॉम्पिटिशन.
हाँ
हाँ इसे कल्चर है. हाँ हाँ तो क्या होता है वो दोनों चीज़ें मिक्स होती हैं. हम अभी वेस्टर्न वर्ल्ड, हम अभी मॉडर्न वर्ल्ड में हैं तो हम मॉडर्न चीज़ें एक्सपीरियंस करते हैं. हम बहुत सारी चीज़ें अब हमने मिक्स मैच करनी स्टार्ट की है. हम एक लॉन्ग कुर्ता पहन लेते हैं, उसके ऊपर कुछ और जैकेट पहन लेते हैं, तो दे आर लॉट्स ऑफ थिंग्स मिक्स मैच हो रहा है. वेस्टर्न कल्चर, इंडियन कल्चर, बहुत सारी चीज़ें हो रही हैं. बट मैं ये बोल रहा हूँ कॉम्पिटिशन नहीं हो सकता. हम वाई वी विल कॉम्पीट विद दोज गाइस, ज़रूरत नहीं है. फैशन लवर, डेफिनेटली फैशन लवर एक एक्सपेक्टेशन क्या होती है फैशन लवर की, लवर्स की, वो हमेशा एक ही चीज़ है कि आपको कुछ नया मिले देखने को, विच हम किसी को वो इंस्पायर कर सके, किसी को एस्पायर कर सके कि यार कुछ नया हो रहा है, ये अच्छा कर रहा है, ये नया कर रहा है, ये इसने कुछ नया किया है, जो कि हमारी ड्यूटी है, हमको वैसा ही करना चाहिए, राइट. बिकॉज समवेयर हम फील करते हैं कि जो आपके डिज़ाइन, जो डिज़ाइनर्स होते हैं, दे एक्चुअली ट्रेंड फोरकास्ट, दे सेट फोरकास्ट ट्रेंड, राइट. उसमें क्या होता है, वो लोग दिखाते हैं कि हम क्या करना चाहते हैं, व्हाट इज़ द ट्रेंड, इस ट्रेंड को कैसे हम पोर्ट्रे करना चाहते हैं, इन आर मैनर, इन समबडी मैनर, समथिंग. तो हम बेसिकली समवेयर डिज़ाइनर जॉब इज टू सेट द ट्रेंड. तो सिमिलरली जो नए लोग आएंगे उनका भी यही रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटी बनता है. दे शुड फर्स्ट थिंक कि मैं क्या क्रिएट कर रहा हूँ, सो दैट मैं अपने लिए एक पोजिशन क्रिएट कर सकूँ मार्केट में, इंडिविजुअल पोजिशन, कि हाँ सो सच एंड सच डिज़ाइनर इज़ नोन फॉर सच एंड सच क्वालिटी. नहीं तो मैं कोई और डिज़ाइनर हूँ, मैं कोई और डिज़ाइनर, नहीं तो मैं अपना डिज़ाइन अजय कुमार क्यों हूँ, राइट.
मैं
हाँ इस बार है, इस बार भी है हमारा. तो ये बहुत ज़रूरी है और सब सारे लोग इंडिविजुअल हैं, सबको अपनी अपनी इंडिविजुअलिटी और अपने डिज़ाइन दिखाने और क्या, और इंस्पायर करना है लोगों को.
थैंक यू सो मच,
थैंक्स अ लॉट.
यस, इट्स
अ सुपर सुपर इनिशिएटिव सर, थैंक यू सो मच.
रोल
फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वेलकम
लिटिल आउट ऑफ
6 डिग्री. एक इनिशिएटिव ले रहा है लैक में फैशन वीक के साथ एंड यू आर एसोसिएटेड विद थर्ड, दिस इज द थर्ड ईयर, राइट?
यस.
आई वांट टू नो हाउ दिस आईडिया हैज कम टू योर माइंड कि मतलब हम न्यू टैलेंट्स को एक्सप्लोर करें,
राइट,
डिजाइनर्स को स्पेशली,
राइट. See, India today has more than 7 lakh designers and we have about 100 odd fashion weeks. But every designer wants to take their label to the next level, right? And Lakme Fashion Week is that platform which puts India on the fashion map. It's such a big platform. And given that we have an association with them, we constantly want to bring new fashion talent on bigger platforms. Because there is so much of talent, but who's going to go down and find people, say from Rajasthan to Tamil Nadu or from Guwahati to Kerala. So that's where 6 Degree plays a major role in finding fresh talent and bringing them the best opportunity to showcase at fashion weeks. Like it can be Lakme Fashion Week or it can be international, like India Fashion Week, London or in Dubai or, you know, even Fiji or even within India itself. So that's how we are working.
Okay. Or regional to fashion to shows, when we associate.
So today we have more than 15 fashion weeks whom we work with. Ya to Mysore ho gaya, or we have Pune Fashion Week or India Beach Fashion Week. So we have fashion week or in Chennai or in Kerala or in Bangalore for the matter. So almost in every state we are trying to establish our footprint. But from a national scale we also have Lakme.
And you also provide platforms to them.
Sorry?
And you also provide platforms to all the newcomers.
Yes.
On these platforms.
Yes. So, yeah, not just the Fashion Week platform, but later we help them grow their business as such by providing fashion services like portfolio shoots or PR services or styling services. So at the end of the day, our vision is that we want to be with a fashion designer or fashion professional from the beginning till the end. So like a A to Z of their fashion journey.
Would you like to share something about the talents newcomers? But कहाँ से वो आते हैं और कितने difficulties उन्हें face करने पड़ती हैं, कितने barriers आते हैं? Would you like to share?
See, in any profession, there is going to be a competition. Now, when we have a simple number, 7 lakh designers. So one designer is competing with the other 6,99,000 designers, right? So there has to be one differentiating factor at least where designer A is better than designer B. Or I wouldn't say better, but I would say different from designer B. So, which is where our own in-house team actually helps working with designers to say that aapka USP kya hai? What is it that you are good in? And how can we bring that to the market to show you're a different element here? So this is where we closely work with. Every designer is different. Every designer is unique.
Any compliment that you got, did you get from renowned personalities from the fashion industry?
Sorry?
Any compliment that you get from renowned
So whoever we have called in for the workshop today or even associations when we have at Lakme, this concept of 6 degree as a fashion talent and tech company is a very new concept in India. So today, finally, India has that one platform where the fashion industry comes together, be it online or offline. And that is what 6 degree is providing to the Indian fashion industry today. So that's the reason today we have such a privileged partnership with Lakme. And this is where the journey continues.
Thank you so much for talking to us. And we really appreciate the initiative you have taken and you are exploring new talents.
Thank you so much. Thank you so much.